So, you just bought yourself a brand new monitor, one of those fancy 144Hz ones, but you're not really sure that you're actually running what says on the package. This is how you're gonna make sure that you're running what you paid for. The first thing you wanna do is make sure you use the right connectors, okay? Cause that is very important. Jokes aside, HDMI does not support the refresh rate over 60Hz normally at full 1080p. This is a DisplayPort, and this is a HDMI. You can see the difference. It's not really that big, but the HDMI has like cut off both corners, where DisplayPort only got one of the corners cut off. They're pretty similar. DisplayPort, it's totally fine and supports G-Sync and 144Hz. This is a dual link DVI cable that is also support the 144Hz but does not support G-Sync. This is a normal DVI cable. This is not a dual link. You can see there are pins missing, and therefore does not support the 144Hz. Here you can see the back of the graphics card. You can see the two DVI outputs. There's a small number printed into the I/O. This one says 1, this one says 2. You always want to use the one that says 1, just to make sure you're not doing something wrong, really. In some cases, if you're running a dual monitor setup, and let's say you have bought a new monitor that is 144Hz and the old one is only 60Hz. If you put the 60Hz into the number 1 output and the new monitor that supports the 144Hz into the second output, you might only be limited to the 60Hz on both monitors. So always make sure that you're running the fastest monitor on the number 1 output. I just seen online that that can be issues. What else? Oh yeah, you can see there's a difference in these two plugs, that one of them has like a star and the other one is just a small line. That's because the one with the star and also the number one, the first output, also supports the VGA adapter. This is a VGA, that is an old cable you probably used at your school. The plugs right here is an analog signal, which is the one that VGA is using. And here you can see it as well, it says VGA and DVI, as this one is only DVI. So the little star means that supports their converter plug thing. Okay, if you got your cables and you got a monitor that supports it, you go into right click your desktop, screen resolution, advanced settings, and then you want to go into your monitor. In here it says screen refresh rate, and here you should be able to see all of the available refresh rates for your monitor. If you do not see them in here, your cable is broken, or you're using the wrong input on your monitor, or your drivers hasn't recognized that your monitor actually supports the 144Hz. Okay, let's okay that. You can also go into NVIDIA control panel, and then you want to go into configure surround physics, and in here you can see that I'm using the first output on my graphics card, the one with the star, and I have a BenQ XL2420T connected, and that is a dual link DVI cable I'm using. You can also go into change resolution, and in here you can see all the available refresh rates. If, like I said before, if your monitor does not show any other available refresh rates, but you know your cable is correct and you know that your monitor does support it, you can go into customize here, and then you can create a custom resolution, and then you can actually create a resolution. You can't create one that's already in here, but you can create a refresh rate. I can put one here where I have a 1080p and 100 and let's say just 40Hz, and I can press the test button. the screen is gonna flash, and mine says out of range, so mine does not support 40 hertz for some weird ass reason. But in here you can test if your monitor does support it. Just a little thing, but always keep your drivers up to date. It should fix all the problems. Oh yeah, the next thing I want to show you is I just want to run FRAP so you can see the FPS counter down the corner. You want to launch your favorite game or the game you want to use your new refresh rate on. Yeah, skip that menu, please. You want to go into your console and you want to type FPS underscore max, and if you set it to 60, you can see I'm going to get limited down here in the corner to 60 frames a second. If I say FPS underscore max 144, okay, it only goes to 120 in the menu. But if I launch play, find a game, nope, play from the bots, and the bots, please go. In the menu and in the loading screen, you can't really depend on your monitor because it's random, really. But as soon as you're in game, it should say 144 hertz, like constantly, please. Okay. Yeah, it's pretty constant. Normally, I run FPS underscore max. I can spell max, and I'm just saying 500, because you know more is always better, guys. More is better. More headshot is better. You know, more chickens. You're just gonna win all the games. So put in the max. Oh, one more thing. You want to make sure that you go into your radio settings, and you want to have VSync disabled. That also is gonna limit your monitor to a refresh rate of the what you set in what you put in here. Settings. If you put on VSync, it's only gonna run 144 hertz. Okay, that should be it, guys. Good luck and GG, make some headshots. See you.